AI is used everywhere these days and has become integrated into daily life, from social media feeds to music, video streaming services, and even more. You might feel disconnected from AI because it seems like such a big topic, but it's closer to you than you think. Sarah, what are some quick examples of AI that you have used in your life?
So top of mind is music or streaming services. So these apps make recommendations using AI to present a playlist or a content selection based on your unique profile, listening, and watching habits. I love this because I can start my favorite playlist on my long drives into the city, and I know that it will automatically play the songs that I frequently listen to. Another one is something that we use quite often, and it's our phones. And so the camera app uses AI to optimize your camera settings for you, and it can also take snapshots of people in your photos, specifically in your inner circle, and through facial recognition features, it can curate all of those individuals into an individual folder. And so this has been a game changer in my household. My toddler has recently fell in love with looking at videos and photos of himself, and so rather than scrolling through my entire camera roll, I can just tap on his face and get a whole curated list of all of the photos and videos that he's present in.
Well, that's super cute. Okay, I hear about AI in the education space a lot. And while we know there's some common pitfalls, what are some ways that we can leverage AI for good when it comes to learning?
Sure, there are actually lots of great ways to bring AI into the classroom and into the workplace. So the first one really is around research. AI language models can be an amazing starting place to get started with a research assignment and really think about the foundation information that you're looking for. Brainstorming is another great use of AI. If you just want to get creative, you want to throw ideas out there, you want to see what comes back, AI tools can help generate new and novel ideas. And then the last one is tutoring. It's a great tool to provide customized and tailored learning opportunities for individual students, and AI is really used effectively in that way. But of course, like all tools, AI is meant to be a supplementary to your work, and we should really make sure that it's not replacing it. And it's especially important for students to remember that AI tools should always be used responsibly. You should think about them just like you would any other form of software and technology, and make sure that you're not passing off AI-generated content as your own. There's also pressure on educators and schools, universities, and colleges to clarify if, when, and how AI can be used. But there's also pressure on them to figure out effective ways of detecting AI-generated content. So I think it's really important for educators, teachers, professors to think about how to use AI in the classroom in a really positive way, rather than trying to catch people who are maybe misusing it. Let's think about how we can build it into our teaching and our curriculum to help build really active and positive research and critical thinking skills.
Great. So next, we're going to chat about some myths and misconceptions when it comes to AI, so keep watching to learn more.